Hey guys, I'm back, and this right here is going to be my second look. I'm still prepping for the holiday season, and you know, New Year's is right around the corner. So not only am I prepping for myself, but I'm also prepping for some clients that I have booked. So I'm really excited to do this look. I really want it to go sexy, but sultry, but very, very natural and neutral. So I think I really achieved it with this look. I love the cut crease, the very subtle glitter outline. So without further ado, let's get started. The first thing I'm gonna take is a cotton swab and this skin prep. I'm using this interchangeably with a primer. This is something that dancers usually use when they perform, sweat and everything. Especially for my oily girls, this is going to be your holy grail. It comes on as a liquid and you put it on. After it dries for a couple minutes, you'll start to feel it feels something like a skin peel. But as soon as you put your foundation on, it's going to be perfect. Next, I'm going to use an eyebrow primer. This is from Flowmore, but you can find this in pretty much any brand. I love eyebrow primers because it keeps my eyebrows long lasting and it also keeps my eyebrow hairs in order. So for the ladies that have curly eyebrows, this is going to be a great tip for you. You're going to use any spoolie to just brush your hairs up and over just to prep your eyebrows. Next, I'm going to have a angled brush. This one is from Sephora and my Anastasia Beverly Hills pomade. This one is in ebony. I absolutely love this stuff. I'm looking for something else. All the other dip brows that I've used so far I haven't really loved, but I'm still looking, ladies, so I'll keep you posted. This is pretty much the same way I do my eyebrows in my eyebrow tutorial that I posted a couple weeks ago, so go check that out if you need more tips. Excuse my random antics. I was listening to music. I had to, you know, entertain myself some way. And this is the finished product. Next, you're going to take a concealer. Mine is the Radiant Creamy Concealer from NARS. I love this concealer. You'll see me use it all the time. I'm actually using the wand that they provide and actually putting the concealer right on my face. I'm not getting close to my eyebrows because I will use a brush to get as close as possible. But I'm just putting the concealer right on there and then we'll clean it up in a minute. Now I'm going to use this base that I bought a couple days ago from NYX. It's white and creamy, but I actually really, really love it. It's been keeping my eyelids from getting really dry. I don't know if anybody else goes through that, but I tend to see sometimes from using eyeshadow a lot, my eyelids get dry. So this has been really great. I'm just going to buffer it in with a blending brush. And voila! Next, I'm gonna set my concealer underneath my eyebrows and my NYX eyelid primer with the Laura Mercier translucent powder. I'm not even gonna take that out because I want y'all to know I am human too, but this is pretty much all I'm gonna do.
Now I'm using the Anastasia Beverly Hills Modern Renaissance eyeshadow palette. I'm using these two colors here interchangeably because they're very close to my skin color, and I'm going to use this as my base, and I'm literally putting this all over my eye. Next, I'm going to use this darker rosy color down here, just for my transitional color. And you're gonna see I'm gonna put it right in my crease, and then I'm gonna blend it up just a little bit. It's not too much of a different color. That's how you get a smooth transition, especially if you're not that good with eyeshadows. You wanna find colors that, you know, kinda gradually go into each other, kinda like a gradient. Next, I'm going to use this darker brown. I'm going to keep this right in my crease and not blending up too much. Like I said, you want to make a gradient, and this is pretty much how it comes out. Now it's time for the cut crease. I'm going to use this Pro Conceal in medium beige to start to outline my cut crease. I'm going to apply it right with the brush that they give me. And I don't have a perfect hand, guys. So as you see, you know, it's not perfect. So don't be dismayed if, you know, it comes out a little crazy. Practice makes perfect. So keep trying, keep trying, keep trying. So now I'm going to take this shimmery champagne color here, and I'm going to put it all over where I used the concealer, and that's going to be my actual cut crease. Later I'm going to put on some glitter, so it's going to actually cover up any imperfections that I have between my brown color and this champagne color. So, you know, don't even worry about it if it looks a little crazy. Next, I'm going to use this Anastasia Beverly Hills Stick Foundation in Chestnut. I'm just going to actually apply it right to my face, and then just blend it out with a brush, to be honest. I don't really like to use a blending sponge with this because I like to keep it as controlled as possible. So I actually, oh my god, I can't believe I taped that. Sorry, guys. So after I did all that blending, I'm going to go back in with the NARS concealer and start to do my highlight underneath my eyes, down my nose, my forehead, and my chin. So for this next step, you're going to need two of these little sponges. They're going to be expensive at Walmart. I spray one with either call a setting spray or my fix spray from MAC. I'm literally blending my concealer out. And I do one part of my face at a time. And I'm gonna blend. Then I'm gonna take another one of these sponges and put my Butterscotch powder, setting powder, right on top. Once this is done all over your face, you're going to take any pressed powder that goes close to your skin complexion. Mine is from MAC, and it's their mineralized pressed powder. And you're going to use it to brush away your setting powder. I do this if I have a setting powder with a tint to it. I don't do it if I'm using a setting powder that's translucent. You take the pain away. I'm so in love with you. Next, I'm going to use a combination of MAC and NARS Deep Deep Colors for my contour. I've used this many, many times, so if you need an in-depth explanation, please look at some of my old videos. Today I really wanted to glow, so I'm going to use a liquid highlighter and a powder one. This one is from Benefit and is their Sun Dip. I absolutely love it. You really can't put too much of this stuff on your face, but because I'm using a powder one too, I'm going to be a little more reserved with it. Now I'm going to clean up that cut crease with this liquid liner, glitter liner from Ulta. It's beautiful. It's not too glittery, but it's absolutely just right. I had to do two layers. I did another layer off camera, but literally I would just wait for it to dry and then just see if you need to add a little more. Now I'm going to use Ulta's gel liner. I absolutely love this stuff. I've had it for about a year now, and because I've had it so long and it has not dried out, I will not give up on this liner. I'm going to use my angled brush and I'm just going to do my wing liner. It's not going to come out perfect, so I am going to go back in with a liquid liner with a fine tip to just, you know, make it look as presentable as possible. It's not perfect, I promise you, because I'm not, but it's as good as it's gonna get. Now I'm using a lip liner from MAC in Chestnut, and I'm using their lipstick in Velvet Teddy. I love this combination so much. It's very subtle but very glamorous at the same time.
You make me happy, you make me whole. You take the pain away, I'm so in love with you. You make me happy, you make me whole. You take the pain away, I'm so in love with you.
Guys, I'm all done. I went and changed because I have to head to work, but I really do hope you enjoyed this. I think this is a strong candidate for New Year's. I might want to go a little more glamorous, but I actually don't know what I'm doing yet. So just don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe, and I will be back with much more. See you soon.